What a strike by Bassa. I don't know, something about these balls in here, I think they fly, you know. Mauricio knows it hit him, but people like that, Bassa, you know, if he gets anywhere around that yellow line, I think he's just have a smash at it, you know. Anything can happen in this, in indoor.
Mauricio steps into it, outside, Miller's shot, good save by Richie. Back in front, Salas cleared off the line, Basso shot, trickles in! 2-2!
Brilliant. Brilliant, there you go, I need to mention his celebration. Here's another one, he had a chalk down today, he said he's going to score, and I had a look at his dodgy celebration there, so I won't mention too much about it.
That's his first goal of the year. Give him some slack.
There you go, but it's a great goal, but yeah, dancing needs to be worked on, I think. quality stuff, brilliant stuff. Just like we talked about, he created it with his shot in the first half. Comes off Doug and comes off the board, you know, ricochets. That's like we talked about so many times indoor. And I think it's great composure from a defender, you know. It comes back out, he pops it off his knee, and there's his dodgy celebration.
We'll see if Mauricio gets the assist. Chicago putting the pressure deep in the Lancers' half of the field.
Yeah, it's a strange one tonight. It's playing a lot, playing a lot more like a more relaxed soccer game.
Outside to Mauricio. Oh, a good ball, and Boughton easily taps it home. You sat back. You like that one, huh, Danny?
There we go. Yeah, exactly. That was unbelievable. Hey, that's Mauricio as well. Fast breaks, that's great. Like I said, it's like more a realistic soccer game tonight, you know. Yep. Two teams are keeping possession, and that's what outdoor soccer is all about, with counter-attack and making the right choices. That's a big part of it. People think it's okay to run out from the back as quick as you can, but you've got to have the right players in the field to make the right choices, and that was exactly it there. Great play by Gary, and Jimmy beat the lighter with him. See, he is. Brayton makes the right choice, plays Mauricio, and then Mauricio, there you go, experience, making the right choice. Like I said, he's 5 yards out, and you expect him to shoot, but sees Gary in a better position, has the ability to pick him out, and obviously Gary knocks it in with a plum. Great goal.
Knocks it in with a plum. Mesa turning and coming forward now. Nicely intercepted. Foskey back to Knapp on the outside. Shot wide of the goal. He had Mauricio wide open at the top of the arc. Another chance. Knapp makes the most of it. He fires it down the middle of the net.
Incredible. What a strike. You see Brayton threatening every game, you know, coming off from the back and taking those long shots, and oh, he'll be elated with that. What a strike.
A laser from Brayton Knapp. He's got his first goal of the season.
See, coming in, he starts to play off of that bending shot anyway. He comes in, follows it up. Ah, oh, brilliant, brilliant. Dougie picks him out, you know. See, Dougie's clever enough to pick him out, no one on him. Brayton comes in. That's a hard technique, I tell you what. That is a hard technique. Hitting that ball, facing away from the goal across your body and top corner, that's a hard technique. Fair play.
Halftime at the Blue Cross Arena, the Rochester Lancers and the Chicago Soul doing battle on the turf in downtown Rochester. Well, last game we had an NFL player join us as our guest. Tonight we step off the playing field, we roll out the red carpet, and we welcome the lovely and talented Ashley Michelson up to the box for our halftime. Ashley, welcome to Rochester. How you doing?
Very good. Thank you so much for having me.
What brings you up to Rochester tonight?
I'm here for Thanksgiving, for the holidays, and I'm here to watch the Rochester Lancer game, and I've never been, so I'm super excited.
You are going to love this game. It is absolutely nonstop action, end to end, and it's a pleasure to have you here tonight. But you've been on TV, you've been a model, but tonight you're here in a different capacity. Maxim Magazine's Hometown Hottie. Can you talk about that?
I tried out for a contest. It's called Maxim's Hometown Hottie Contest, and I went from over 2,000 applicants to top 100 to top 10. So now we're currently in the top 10. Everyone has to get their votes in at Maxim.com, and hopefully I can be the winner of this and bring it home for Rochester.
You got my vote today, there's no doubt about it. And you can vote every day, correct?
Every day until November 29th, I think it ends. So we should know about mid-December who the winner is.
We were talking off the air before we came on here about what this would lead to if you win the title of Hometown Hottie from Maxim Magazine. Talk about that a little bit.
So basically, if you win, you get the cover of the magazine or a huge spread within the magazine, and you're kind of the spokesmodel for Maxim for a year. You get to go to really cool events like the Super Bowl and the Grammys and a bunch of opportunities just open up, so it would just be really good for my career.
Super Bowl, Grammys, if you need a bodyguard or a
yes, exactly.
A chaperone,
and I'm
going to
bring all of Rochester with me, so keep voting.
So Maxim.com is the website to vote on. Yes. Now, you've been on Law & Order, Sopranos, you even appear as Barbie at Toys R Us and FAO Schwartz. What else is coming down the line?
I do a bunch of things from, like you said, movies and TV shows to billboards. I have a Bare Essentials campaign coming out. I've been on ABC's What Would You Do? I do a little acting here and there. I travel with Monster Energy. I tour with them for Supercross and Motocross, so I get into the sports as well. Just a bunch of stuff, and I'm traveling all over the country. So.
You talk about ABC's What Would You Do? I
yes.
love that show. And sometimes I'm thinking, what would I do? What was your role in that?
So the first time I had to be a really rude waitress. And I just had to be really rude to this lady who was coming in.
I can't see it.
Well, it's acting.
Okay, you're right. Yeah, you got it.
And then another time I actually was a customer sitting down and someone was calling me a dumb blonde the whole time. So you never know what the situation is, but it's awesome. It's a good show, and there's always, like, meaning behind it. So I like being a part of it.
It's a great show. You've done so much. How about soccer? You're from Williamson, New York.
Yes.
Section 5 area for soccer.
Yes.
Did you play?
Exactly. I did. I was center halfback. That was my position, or right or left wing. I can't say I was really that good, but I was super aggressive, and they always kicked me off because I would just, like, kick the girls left and right. I just kept kicking the ball, but I had no strategy.
Well, indoor soccer is going to give you some strategy and some great ideas here tonight. You're here visiting family. How often do you get back to Rochester?
Luckily, I get to come back a lot. I'm back and forth between California and New York, so when I'm in New York, I always make sure to see my family, my friends, my boyfriend in Rochester.
Wonderful. Hey, we wish you the best of luck.
Thank you one more time.
MISL Magazine's hometown hottie,
yes.
Ashley Michelson.
Go vote.
How do they vote? What do they do?
Go to MISL.com, look for the hometown hotties link, click Ashley, and click the red button, vote. That easy.
We wish you the best of luck. And a little secret, I used to model. It was sock modeling.
Don't tell anybody. Happy Thanksgiving, guys.
The lovely and talented Ashley Michelson joins us here at the Blue Cross Arena. Thank you and best of luck.
Thank you so much.
We'll come back with more halftime show here from the Blue Cross Arena. This is the Lancers Broadcast Network. Here we go. Kletzian gets the kickoff from Radoncic. Nichols forward to Megson. The extended halftime finally comes to a close. A giveaway, Salas. One-timer, Miller. Back to Salas. Handball, no call. Referee has the whistle in his mouth. He's not going to blow it, and Miller scores. The Lancers never quit on the play, and 23 seconds in, they double the lead.
Well, what a run of events that was. Like you said, you screamed for the handball and the referee had it in his mouth, but I think you got to give credit to the referee there. He let play go on, see what happened. I think he would have called it back if nothing happened, but Doug capitalized, which is great for us. What a start to the second half. What a start.
It's 8-4. Doug Miller's got his sixth goal of the season.
You know, comes here. He didn't show the handball beforehand, but what a goal by Doug. What a goal. You see Jake comes in. Here we go. Pops off the hand there, definitely a handball for sure. Comes back out to Jake, plays a little side foot off the wall, you know, Doug's alive as ever, and like I said, in the first half, you know, you can't keep Doug quiet for long.
Sure can. He comes out storming and pounding on the glass. Ortiz, shot, goal! I don't think Richie knew much about it.
There we go, the lad we talked to just before the game, Jeremy Ortiz, and like I keep on saying, it's no mystery, you know, you got to feed the players that are in form, you know, that's football, that's any sport, you know, and Jeremy's been bang on form since he came back for us, and here we go, Maurizio, great hold-up play again, another assist, and smashes it from outside the arc in the bottom corner, keeper's got no chance.
That is three assists for Maurizio Salas, and Richie was not going to touch that one, and Ortiz has got goal number three.
And something we talked about last week, me and Maurizio, he's looking to get more people involved in the game. You know, he gets doubled and triple-teamed every game, you know, because obviously he's a dangerous player, and he's looking to bring more lads into play, and three assists tonight shows what a quality player he is.
All right, fans, put your eyes on the field, because there they are, your Lancer Dancers. rocks your world like the Lancer Dancers. The Lancer Dancers are brought to you by Golden Tans and TJT Photography.
The left foot shot, goal! Brayton Knapp has got him laced up tonight. Second of the evening.
Incredible, what a goal. What a strike, he's on a foot as well. God, he's displaying all sorts of techniques tonight. Incredible, out of nothing as well. Out of nothing, right foot, first time, left foot, this one doesn't matter what foot, he's going in the back of the net. There it is, you see him, he takes a touch, unbelievable finish. I'm left footed and that's a hard shot for me, that's his weak foot, you know, comes out. See Ray holding it up, pops it out, and great technique, head over the ball, strikes through it, and up off the keeper's right shoulder, the keeper had no chance.
Martinez should get the assist, correct? Is it Ray who touched it there?
Looked like it, yeah, Ray held it up and popped it off to him, yeah, brilliant.
Martinez goes on the books for his fourth assist of the season.
Doing great tonight, fair play to him.
Shots, 18-16 in favor of the Lancers. Here's Mauricio, good ball to Enrique, back across, Miller, goal! We're talking highlight reel there, that's a pretty soccer goal.
As you say, that's a great soccer goal. I don't think there's any real individual brilliance. No, it's a great pass in from Rizzo, and really, really impressed with Enrique there because, like I said, we're 14-6 up, and he could have took a chance to take a shot, but he sees Dulles in a better position and picks him out. Unselfish play. Here we go, Rizzo. Ah, splitting the pass. Splitting the defense with a pass, Rizzo. Unbelievable. And then Enrique slots in the door. Great finish. There we go. Dulles always ready. He's a six. Six-yard box play, you know, he doesn't move a lot away from there, but he always puts it in the back of the net, which is brilliant.
Everyone up and having a good time here tonight. The Lancers have a 16-6 lead. This is the Lancers Broadcast Network. So final score tonight, the Lancers 16, the Chicago Soul 8. It's the second meeting of the season between Rochester and Chicago. So far, the Lancers have Chicago's number at 2-0, but it's not too long until these two teams do battle again on December the 7th at Chicago, and then again on February the 8th at Chicago. And the Soul, they are done coming to Rochester, at least as far as the regular season is concerned. Soccer Sam will speak with a Lancer player, and I'm sure hopefully the head coach, Jimmy Hesch, momentarily. Lancers out shooting Chicago 19-17. And can only imagine what Soccer Sam has up his sleeve.
Thanks, Joe. We're down here now with Enrique from Costa Rica. Enrique, two assists tonight, a couple of the other game. First year indoor player. You played futsal for years. Tell us how you feel about the indoor game.
Well, it's totally different. It's a little bit faster and, you know, excited. These people, it's fun, you know. I like the fans and, you know, it's the best.
Now, Enrique, now you in Costa Rica, do you celebrate Thanksgiving or not?
Oh, yeah, we do, of course. You know, turkey is everywhere, right? Yeah.
So you do the turkey thing in Costa Rica?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, we want to wish the fans, all right, happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving to everyone. And have a good Thanksgiving for everyone. Yeah.
All right, Jimmy Hesch, baby, what a victory. This team is on fire. Coach Hesch, these guys are determined. All these fans constantly are coming up to me saying, this team's playing so great. Proud of you tonight.
Thank you. Thanks, everybody, for coming. Have a happy holiday. We've been working hard in training since day one, and it's all finally starting to click, come together.
Yeah. Now, Jim, I've seen a lot of, like, different changes in lineup and stuff, moving guys around a lot. You're kind of still experimenting, I take it.
Yeah, we're using the first few games to try different things, try different personnel, and then come into the season, we'll have our guys and we'll get things done.
Now, you got family watching all over the country. It's a big day tomorrow, big festive day. Want to say something nice?
No, happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Drive safe, travel safe. Don't eat too much.
Jimmy Hashke. All right, Jim, thank you. Mauricio Salas from Brazil. Brother Mauricio, come on over here. Mauricio. Amazing game again, big victory. Playing hard, playing your heart out. You told me last week you gave it your all, and we came up short, but tonight, baby, this team was on fire.
Yeah, very happy we got the win. it was a big win for us. And happy to see every game, the fans here. It's like a great atmosphere here. And we all play here for you guys. If you guys don't come, we probably quit, everybody. Please keep coming. We're going to keep working as hard as we can for you guys.
All right, Mauricio, happy Thanksgiving to you and your family, and have a great day tomorrow.
Yeah, happy Thanksgiving for all you guys, too.
All right, Mauricio Salas, fans, we'll see you December 1st. On behalf of the entire ownership group and Louie, have yourself a great, great Thanksgiving. Louie, be careful. Someone might take you for a turkey. Something might happen to you. Be careful. You better hide tonight. Easy. Easy. See you next time. Back to you, Joe.
All right, Soccer Sam. Always entertaining. Thank you very much. We're going to wrap up this one on the TV side. Danny, great job as usual. I wish you and the rest of the crew a happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you very much. Same to you.
2-2. The Lancers are now at the 500 mark. On TV, we wrap it up. Radio, stick around for a brief recap. Rochester wins it 16-8 for John Catalano and the entire crew. I'm Joe Giuliano saying good night from the Blue Cross Arena.